Hey everyone, welcome back. Today I'm going to show you how to make a Selena Quintanilla MAC lipstick nail. So to start off, I'm going to use a clear nail tip. You can sculpt the nail if you would like, but I prefer tips. So I'm just going to apply that and then go ahead and finish applying the other nail to my finger. I did do a complete Selena Quintanilla set, and I will leave the link down below if you would like to check out how I did the rest of the nails. So now you want to go ahead and trim the nail however long you would want it. And then with a pair of scissors, I find this the easiest, go ahead and cut at an angle. And you can point the angle either way you'd like. So now with a nail file, I'm just going to kind of fix up the shape. I don't really need much reshaping, but I'm going to file a little bit. But what I'm doing here is blending in the nail tip to the natural nail. And from here on out, you can either go ahead and use acrylic or gel or whatever other kind of method that you use. You could even use a full nail tip if you just use like the press-ons and just use a longer one and then go ahead and cut it the way I showed you. And then you'd go ahead and paint it the way I'm about to show you how to paint it. But I use gel, so I will show you the gel process. And right here, I will show you the time where you can skip ahead to the design if you would like. I'm just going to go ahead and finish out the gel process, which now I'm going to be putting two coats of my gel primer. And then I'm going to go in with my clear builder gel, and I'm just going to do a base layer. After you do the base layer, you're going to go ahead and clean off the sides. I like to use this cuticle pusher. It's the perfect little spoon to scoop out the cuticle area and get all the gel out from there. After that, I go ahead and I do a full cure in my lamp. Cure your gel in the lamp that it is for and the time that it says. And now I'm going to go in with a small bead of gel. And I like to start right in the apex area, the middle. And then I gently push it towards the back in the cuticle area. And you want to just gently do it and don't put it all the way to the cuticle area because it will self-level. And then you'll have a mess if you go too vigorous with it and too quickly. So I just like to slowly do it. Then I did do a flash cure in the lamp, which is 10 seconds. If you experience your gel heating up, go ahead and take your finger out of the lamp and then blow on it for a few seconds and then pop it back into the lamp. And again, I took a second bead of gel and then I started again in the apex area. I feathered it towards the cuticle area a little and then I feathered it to the tip. And since I needed a little bit more in the tip area, instead of getting another bead, I like to do the string method right here on the tip. And again, my gel is self-leveling, so it just pretty much levels itself and it just sculpts itself, basically. I'm sorry, I don't know how to say it. And now I'm going to show you how to file. I like to start off with the sides. You want to make sure that you file anything off the sides that's excess. And then after I do the sides, I like to do the tip. You see me, I do like the sides to be nice and even and kind of curving up. I will show you at the very end how it looks. So I like my nail to be really thin in the tip area and also really thin in the cuticle area. I don't like too much gel back there and it kind of looks like a hump. So I go ahead and I do the cuticle area and I just make it flush to the natural nail, which just means it's even. So at the very end, I go ahead and I file the tip and shape it. It didn't need much shaping, but just want to make sure that it's nice and even. And that's pretty much it, how you file the lipstick nail. Of course, if you are a beginner and you do have a more like a lumpier nail, don't worry, you can just fix it up by filing. Don't get discouraged. So now I'm going to start the actual lipstick design. I have this really pretty red gel polish that I thought would be perfect. I chose the lipstick Como La Flor because it was her signature red lipstick. And I just love, love, love and adore Selena. I've always been a fan of her ever since I was a really little girl. So when MAC came out with this collection, I was so excited, but it sold out literally within minutes and I did not get to get anything, not even one lipstick, and I was really sad. But I did get an email that they are going to release it again in January. So hopefully us ladies that didn't get it the first time will be able to get it the second time. I am going to be on the hunt this time. No prisoners. I don't know. I'm really, really, really excited. I really want it. At least the three lipsticks. Four, sorry. I at least want the four lipsticks. Actually, I think there is only three. Yeah, so after I did that, I did a black line just to represent the black tube. And now I'm going to go in with this purple holographic glitter. I know that the lipstick tube is matte, but I just feel like Selena was just so beautiful and a shining star and always, always had rhinestones and bling. And I just felt like the packaging was a little plain for her. And I wish MAC would have gave her some sparkle in her lipstick tubes. But yeah, so I decided to go with this holographic purple glitter. I just pressed it into some clear top coat and then I'm going to clean up all around the sides and then do a full cure. After that, I do two layers of top coat, curing between each layer. And now I'm going to go on with this decal. I did order these decals from eBay. I will leave the link down below if you're interested. And it just says Selena and her signature font that is gorgeous. I love it. And here I'm just going to be writing out MAC for MAC. And I did make this decal. I just put a layer of clear top coat, did a full cure, cleansed it, and then wrote on top of it. And as you can see, I can cut it out just like you would any water decal. And now I'm going to just stick it on with some more clear top coat. And then after that, I just went ahead and I top coated it just to make sure it was fully secure. I believe I top coated it twice just to make sure. And basically that was it. I just wanted to add a little more bling. So I decided to add these rhinestones. And that's it. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Remember, I will leave the link to the other part of my nails down below. Don't forget to thumbs up and subscribe. Again, I hope you loved this video. Thank you all so much for watching. Bye.